that point, directly we are going to the police station where baby Pochamma is going to the police station to file a false report. Okay, and the false report that she gives is that Velita had come the previous night and he had raped Ammu, and he has done this because he was dismissed from his job at the factory. So our deshatil, he comes and rapes Ammu and he has threatened the family. All right, and she says of how, you know, the child, one child is dead, two children are missing, and it is all his fault, is how he becomes the victim of this thing. And by the time she returns to the house, Chaco and Margaret are back from Cochin, okay, and that is when Sophie Mall's body has been found and it is kept there, and her parents are in shock, and Margaret Kochamma goes into her shock, okay. And Margaret Kochamma, when she sees that she has lost her daughter Sophie Mall, what happens is that she's doubly shocked. When Joe had died, she had managed to, you know, become stable, thinking of her daughter, thinking that her daughter's schedule must not be disturbed. But now that her daughter is also gone, suddenly it is like both of them are gone. All right, and there is nothing to hold her back, so she becomes completely disturbed, and somehow she feels like, why did her daughter die when the other two children have survived? So she is very angry at Esta and Rahel, and whenever she gets a chance, she used to hit Esta, because I don't know how she felt like Esta was responsible for all of this, even though she does not know that Esta was actually responsible for the plan of this boat and the river and going to the history house. But still, in her subconscious mind, she blames Esta for whatever happens to Sophie Mall. All right. And the chapter ends by again coming back to that point where Sophie Mall was waking up and looking at the picture of Chaco and Margaret Kochamma. Okay, and she finds some gifts that she bought from London for her cousins, and she decides to take it to her cousins to become friends with them, because at this point, 2 weeks ago, they have not accepted her as their friend. They see her as someone who has come to take away their love. So she's going with gifts, and probably that is the point where they became friendly, and that is why she also accompanied them on the boat that night. All right. Layers of false information and misunderstandings are built into this chapter. All right. Because first misunderstanding is between Margaret Kochamma and Chaco. She does not really know him very well, but when she gets married to him, she realizes that he's not a person who is fit for her. She's very, very disappointed, and that's why she quickly gets out of the marriage. Chaco comes back to India, and you know, he starts torturing his mother for what happened to him. Torturing not in the sense of torture, but you know, he loves Margaret Kochamma so much that he disregards everyone else. So he has a very much fantastic idea about his wife and his daughter, and Mamachi, who hates them, you know, she's very much disturbed when he keeps talking about them all the time. And Sophie Mall's death is described how, you know, when she's found, she's like a small mermaid who's all wrinkled up because she was in the water. Her eye has been nibbled by the fish. Okay, so that is a very, very disturbing picture that has been presented there. And there's also another character. Remember our Inspector Thomas Matthew, who had assaulted Ammu in the beginning of the chapter. All right. So this, he is also introduced again, and how baby Kochamma is going to him and complaining to him about Velita. What is important here is the way in which she complains. She complains of him as an untouchable, as a paravan, okay? And she says that it's our mistake that we gave him so much freedom. See now what has happened. So this layering of caste is also a very, very important thing that has come there, all right? And Thomas Matthew also, he's very much conscious about the caste, and he realizes, he sees that, you know, this caste hierarchy has been broken down, and that is why he does what he does to Ammu, because he wants to make sure that she knows that, you know, she has gone beyond her limits, and that is why she will be dealt with like a prostitute. So he is a guardian of the caste system, is what we can say at this point. The next chapter, chapter 14, is a relatively smaller chapter. It's called Work is Struggle. Okay, and in this chapter, again, we have, you know, in the previous chapter, we were all built up in tension as to what has happened. And suddenly in the next chapter, she's not describing any of it. Okay, again, she's going back to the past where after Sophie Moll has come, okay, the 2 weeks before her death is the time period here. And the chapter here describes Chako's visit to Colonel K.N.M. Pillai's house, all right, Comrade K.N.M. Pillai's house, where he goes to talk to Pillai about Velita, because he's very much concerned about whether it was Velita that they saw in that Communist Party protest march that they saw. And he goes and talks to Pillai, and Pillai, see, he's a Marxist communist person, but what he says is that Velita will create problems for you, and it's not because he's a part of the party or not, it's because of his caste. He's a Parvan, and you know, among other workers of the factory, he's the only untouchable one. And the caste system is something that has a very, very long history, and even though I don't believe in it, we have to follow it, okay? Is something that he says. And even though Comrade Pillai's role is not known, we know that towards the end of the chapter, the Marxists come and they attack the factory, and they take whatever it is theirs, and the factory is closing. All right, so they're losing their livelihood, they're losing their factory. And Chako, this is after Sophie Moll's death, he leaves for Canada. All right, he's leaving India for Canada, and Baby Kochamma and Kochumariya are left alone, and their only means of income after the factory is closing is from the rubber plantation and coconut trees that are left on the family property. All right, 2 weeks later, after all this, Velita did not know what had happened. Okay, he had been in Kottayam for factory business, and he is called back when a fellow worker sees him in the bus stand. He's asked to go and meet Mamachi. So when Velita goes to see Mamachi in IMNM house, she's very, very angry. He does not know what has happened, right? She is very angry. So she says that he must leave IMNM forever because of his affair with Ammu, all right? And he leaves the house. He's very dejected. He leaves the house. He goes to meet Comrade Pillai, but Pillai does not want to get involved with this scandal. So he has nowhere else to go, and that's why he goes to the river. He crosses the river and goes to the history house, all right? So more details about the looming tragedy, the tragedy that is to come, that is Sophie Moll's death, is being described to us, and it's shown how, you know, it's not just that one person of the family is dead. They're also losing their factory, all right? And this whole communist movement and the caste system crossing paths with each other is another very important theme of this particular chapter, all right? And Comrade Pillai, okay, he is a high caste man, as his name shows, but how he is, you know, even though he is a high caste man, and instead of supporting his ideas of Marxism, he is supporting the caste system. So that is something also that is much interesting in this particular chapter.